welcome the co-founder of WeVolver and member of InMove Robots for Good, Richard Hulskies.
As a 10-year-old kid growing up in a small town, this is what I would dream about every single night. There were two things I loved: building robots and building rockets. And I had set up my own little hackerspace in the attic of our house, and my dad, he would drive me to the local electronics store every single weekend to get me a handed-down CD player or a tape recorder, which I could then skillfully deconstruct. And I would spend hours in that attic, soldering and tinkering. And I'm going to be honest, most of the things I made there, they were not that good. But it didn't matter. I loved deconstructing an old television set and then make something new from that. And my robots, they didn't do much more than, you know, spin around, and they had some blinking lights. And my rockets, they would burn down every single time. But as a kid back then, building those buggy robots and these awfully constructed rockets was basically the best I could do. I had no documentation on how to build these things. I didn't have people around me I could ask questions to or collaborate with. But today, people are building really advanced technologies, people of all ages. And this is happening because the way hardware is getting developed is radically changing. Who is building hardware is changing, and what they're building is changing. And that is happening because the open source software mindset is shifting to hardware. And people have access to digital manufacturing and electronics. And because of this, people are learning new engineering skills. They're solving problems, and they're even starting their own businesses. And that's why I co-founded WeVolver.com. WeVolver is a collaboration platform for hardware development on both public and private projects. On WeVolver, people share the knowledge and files of engineering projects, and others then use those resources to make, improve, and collaborate on those projects. And our users are building drones that explore the deep oceans, low-cost prosthetics, and are even sending satellites out into space. And in this process, they're changing science, education, and economics. And today I'm here to talk about one of my favorite projects on the platform and how it has the potential to change the lives of thousands of children. About a year ago, I met up with a friend of mine who was doing voluntary work at a local children's hospital in London. And he was telling me about the kids who are hospitalized for a longer period of time. And we discussed if there was maybe something we could do for them so we could make their lives at least a bit more fun whilst they were there. And so we talked if there was maybe something we could build that could enable them to explore the outside world from the hospital. And that's when I mentioned a robotics project that had just been documented on WeVolver called InMove. And the InMove is a humanoid robot that you can build with a home 3D printer. And it's designed and manufactured by this modern-day Geppetto called Gaël Langevin. And Gaël is a model maker who lives in Paris. And one day, Gaël got a job to make a robotic hand for a TV commercial. So Gaël made and designed this robotic hand. But what he did after that was really remarkable. He decided to share all the knowledge and files of that hand online. And soon, people all over the world started to make this robotic hand. And that got Gaël super excited, and he decided to develop and build the rest of the robot. And now there's a community of hundreds of people around the world, not just making this robot, but also improving it. People are giving it features like voice recognition and gesture control. And so me and my friend, we started to discuss how we could use Gaël's robot for the plans we had with the children's hospital, since everything was openly available. And what I had also just learned is that one community member, Kevin Waters, who also built this InMove, had connected it to virtual reality, which enables people to look through the robot's eyes and see what the robot sees. And that's how the InMove Robots for Good project was born. The InMove will enable kids in hospital to explore the outside world by using the robot as their personal avatar. They will be able to go where the robot goes and see what the robot sees. And they'll be able to talk to other people and even shake their hands. So we started with the build of the robot, which was fairly easy and low cost. We could 3D print all the parts, and if something broke or didn't fit, we could just reprint it again. We could use off-the-shelf electronics that we bought online, and we tested the virtual reality connection with an easy and simple Google Cardboard. And soon, the project got a lot of media attention. Blogs and mainstream media, they all started to write about it, and even Prince Andrew, when he was visiting our office in London, wanted to meet up with the InMove and shake his hand. And by now, the project was really getting off the ground. But it wasn't always easy. We had a very small team of volunteers, and people had little time. And because the project took much longer than we expected, people got really demotivated. And I remember at one point, we only had half a working robot, and we were really, really doubting if it was ever going to happen. But because of the openness of the project, it kept going. New volunteers kept showing up. And it was super interesting to see the development of the team from local makers to professional 3D printing companies. Everyone wanted to help out. And that's when I got a phone call from the Sacramento Kings here in California. And they told me this project would be the perfect follow-up to a previous project they had done, where they were enabling kids in hospital to visit their games in virtual reality. And this got our team super excited again. And the Kings promised us they would help us find local makers and builders to help build this robot. And within no time, everything was settled and fixed. And last month, we launched the InMove Robots for Good project right here in California. Two local high schools are building the InMove robot as we speak. And when it's finished, it's going to drive through the new Kings Stadium, controlled by kids from the local children's hospital. And not only that, it will also enable the kids from London to visit the Sacramento Kings games. And what's super cool is that if it's successful, we can roll it out across stadiums all over the country. And I see projects like this happen every day. Since the launch of Revolver 18 months ago, more than 500 public projects have been documented. People are building electric skateboards, their own 3D printers, and are even building their own open source cars right in their own garage. The way hardware is getting developed is radically changing. And projects like InMove are just the beginning. And it blows my mind to think about all these millions of people around the world building their own technology. And it excites me that this 10-year-old kid can now build his own drone, exoskeleton, or even his own mini satellite. And he'll be able to find like-minded people to work with, collaborate with, and in time, maybe even start a company with. The sky is literally no more a limit. Thank you.